The alphabet of the archangels. The alphabet of the ark. Language of Metatron. Inside, sacred symbols are inscribed upon alchemically altered golden plates which align the Ark of Grace, an actual physical object designed by the hierarchy to ground higher consciousness on the earth. These sacred symbols are accompanied with correspondent vocables. The alphabet of the Ark is actually another version of what Toth calls the Aegis of Metatron. Each of these symbols and vocables has an angelic energy which is associated with it. The alphabet of the Ark is part of the language of the Metatron, an archangelic alphabet. In the historic Kabbalah, there is a mention of something called the Eye Writings, or Kitab Ein Na'im. According to Toth, the divine language form represented in the alphabet of the Ark is contained within the matrix of the greater archangelic flame script. The actual eye writings are composed of circles and lines in the form of small flames, an encoding of sorts. The symbolic keys to moving into higher worlds of consciousness lie within the archangelic alphabet called the Kitab Ein Na'im. This alphabet or series of symbol codes is representative of the higher template for creation. Higher intelligences such as the Elohim creator beings use this template to project the elements of life itself into Earth. An analogy to demonstrate this principle could be seen in the projection of a movie onto a screen by a high-powered and focused beam of light coming from the projector. The projector and beam of light represent the Elohim creator beings, consciousness, the cellulite and focusing device of the projector representing the template and its synchronization function. The screen represents the magnetic receptacle or matrix which receives the higher image, and the image movie is the creation itself. The cellulite of the archangelic language has a function which also keeps the lesser creation in synchronization with the higher template. Like the focusing device on the projector in our analogy, it is the harmonic resonance of these archangelic letters with both the higher vibratory frequency patterns of God's name and the elements of lesser creation worlds which allows the synchronization to occur. They act as an intermediary transducer, such as a tuning fork which, when struck and then being brought into proximity of another tuning fork, will start the second fork to begin vibrating also. This occurs only if the second fork is tuned to the resonant harmonic of the first fork's note or waveform. Now considering three tuning forks, each one of the second two tuned to a lesser resonant harmonic or slower vibratory frequency before it. Thus, when the first tuning fork is struck and placed into proximity with the second, the third and second now begins to vibrate at its own frequency, and the third also being in the correct position will also begin vibrating at its own frequency pattern. Thus, we can now see that we have three levels of creation, all being put into motion from the first and uppermost level, which vibrates at the highest frequency. So long as the other levels are tuned or synchronized to the first in the manner, then the projection of the higher realm can occur in the lower. The slower vibration of the last tuning fork is a perfect image of the vibration of the higher tuning fork, but the rate of its vibration per unit of time has been slowed down. This is a good simple model to demonstrate the principles involved in the projection of the elements of this world from higher worlds of intelligence. The alphabet of the Ark is one such archangelic language which serves as a middle tuning fork for us. The sacred names of God as we know them on earth are composed of the archangelic alphabet known as the Kitab Ein Na'im, and also include the names of the angelic energies which themselves are serving the purpose and function of being the middle tuning fork and thus the language itself. These sacred names not only serve to provide the template for projecting the reality itself into the first place, but also to redeem it now as well. You see, the earth creation has gotten to be like a tuning fork, which no longer vibrates well back to the divine tuning fork and its angelic intermediary. We must begin by harmonizing our tones of frequency of creation with the highest elements and creations of being. Then, and only then, will we synchronize and synergize our energy patterns so that our consciousness is freed and ascended and lifted as our vibration becomes faster and faster, and we entrain the divine tuning fork and angelic intermediary. In love and light by day and night, always and always, when we know the angelic language of light.